Please stand and face the rear of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Beloved in the Lord, on this most holy night in which our Lord Jesus passed over from death to life, we are gathered here in vigil and prayer. This is the Passover of the Lord, in which by hearing his word and celebrating his sacraments, we share in his victory over sin and death. Let us pray. O God, you are like a refiner's fire, and your spirit enkindles the hearts of your faithful people with the fire of your love. Bless, we implore you, this flame and those who keep this joyful Easter festival, that burning with desire for life with you, we may be found rightly prepared to share in the feast of light, which has no end, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. May the light of Christ, who is risen in glory from the dead, scatter all the darkness of our hearts and minds. The light of Christ. The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Rejoice now, all you heavenly choirs of angels. Rejoice now, all creation. Sound forth trumpet of salvation and proclaim the triumph of a king. Rejoice to all the earth in the radiance of the light now poured upon you, and make brilliant by the brightness of the everlasting king. Know that the ancient darkness has been forever banished. Rejoice, O Church of Christ, clothed in the brightness of this light. Let all this house of God ring out with rejoicing, with the praises of all God's faithful people.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary. We should at all times and in all places praise you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, and your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. For he is the very Paschal Lamb who offered himself for the sin of the world, who has cleansed us by the shedding of his precious blood. This is the night when all who believe in Christ are delivered from bondage to sin and restored to life and immortality. This is the night when Christ, who is the life, arose from the dead. The seal of the grave is broken, and the morning of the new creation breaks forth out of night. How holy is this night when innocence is restored to the fallen, and joy is given to those downcast. How blessed is the night when man is reconciled to God in Christ. Holy Father, accept now the evening sacrifices of our thanksgiving and praise. Let Christ, the true light and morning star, shine in our hearts. He who gives light to all creation, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. In this most holy night, our Savior Christ the Lord broke the power of death and by his resurrection brought life and salvation to all creation. Let us praise the Lord, for he truly keeps his word. The Sun of Righteousness has dawned upon us who have sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The first reading, the account of the creation from Genesis chapters 1 and 2. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be an expanse in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." And God made the expanse and separated the waters that were under the expanse from the waters that were above the expanse. And it was so. And God called the expanse heaven, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. And God said, let the earth sprout vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees bearing fruit in which is their seed, each according to its own kind on the earth. And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed according to their own kinds, and trees bearing fruit in which is their seed, each according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening and there was morning, the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the expanse of the heavens to separate the day from the night. And let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let them be lights in the expanse of the heavens to give light upon the earth. And it was so. And God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. And God set them in the expanse of the heavens to give light on the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the water swarm with swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the expanse of the heavens. So God created the great sea creatures and every living creature that moves, with which the waters swarm, according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. And God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters in the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures according to their kinds, livestock and creeping things and beasts of the earth according to their kinds. And it was so. And God made the beasts of the earth according to their kinds, and the livestock according to their kinds, and everything that creeps on the ground according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them, and God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the heavens and over every living thing that moves on the ground. And God said, behold, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is on the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the heavens, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, God finished his work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it God rested from all his work that he had done in creation. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Almighty God, through your word and spirit, you most wonderfully created all things. And through the word made flesh, you brought new life to fallen humanity. Grant that in your mercy, we may be conformed to the image of him who shares fully in our humanity, even Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The next Regency account of the flood from Genesis 7, 8, and 9. Then the Lord said to Noah, "Go into the ark, you and all your household, for I have seen that you are righteous before me in this generation. Take with you seven pairs of all clean animals, the male and his mate, and a pair of the animals that are not clean, the male and his mate, and seven pairs of the birds of the heavens also, male and female, to keep their offspring alive on the face of all the earth. For in 7 days I will send rain on the earth, 40 days and 40 nights, and every living thing that I have made I will blot out from the face of the ground." And Noah did all that the Lord had commanded him. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, on the 17th day of the month, on that day all the fountains of the great deep burst forth, and the windows of the heavens were open, and rain fell upon the earth 40 days and 40 nights. On the very same day Noah and his sons, Shem and Ham and Japheth, and Noah's wife, and the three wives of his sons with them entered the ark, they and every beast according to its kind, and all the livestock according to their kinds, and every creeping thing that creeps on the earth according to its kind, and every bird according to its kind, every winged creature. They went into the ark with Noah, two and two of all flesh, in which there was the breath of life. And those that entered, male and female of all flesh, went in as God had commanded him. And the Lord shut him in. The flood continued 40 days on the earth. The waters increased and bore up the ark, and it rose high above the earth. The waters prevailed and increased greatly on the earth, and the ark floated on the face of the waters. At the end of 40 days, Noah opened the window of the ark that he had made and sent forth a raven. It went to and fro until the waters were dried up from the earth. Then he sent forth a dove from him to see if the waters had subsided from the face of the ground. But the dove found no place to set her foot, and she returned to him to the ark, for the waters were still on the face of the whole earth. So he put out his hand and took her and brought her into the ark with him. He waited another 7 days, and again he sent forth the dove out of the ark. And the dove came back to him in the evening, and behold, in her mouth was a freshly plucked olive leaf. So Noah knew that the waters had subsided from the earth. Then he waited another 7 days, and sent forth the dove, and she did not return to him any more. In the 601st year, in the first month, the first day of the month, the waters were dried from off the earth. And Noah removed the covering of the ark, and looked, and behold, the face of the ground was dry. In the second month, on the 27th day of the month, the earth had dried out. Then God said to Noah, "Go out from the ark, you and your wife, and your sons' wives with you. Bring out with you every living thing that is with you of all flesh, birds and animals, and every creeping thing that creeps on the earth, so they may swarm on the earth and be fruitful and multiply on the earth." So Noah went out, and his sons and his wife and his sons' wives with him. Then God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "Behold, I establish covenant with you and your offspring after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the livestock, and every beast of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. It is for every beast of the earth. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of the flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." And God said, "This is a sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for all future generations. I have set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us pray. O Lord, you kill and you raise to life. You brought the flood upon a wicked and perverse generation, and yet you saved faithful Noah and his family in the ark. Keep us in safety in the ark of Christ's body, the church, that your mercy may come to its fullness and your salvation be preached to the ends of the earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Israel's deliverance at the Red Sea from Exodus chapters 14 and 15. When Pharaoh drew near, the people of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians were marching after them, and they feared greatly. And the people of Israel cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, "Is it because there are no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us in bringing us out of Egypt? Is this not what we said to you in Egypt? Leave us alone that we may serve the Egyptians. For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness." And Moses said to the people, "Fear not. Stand firm and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will work for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to be silent." The Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me? Tell the people of Israel to go forward. Lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the people of Israel may go through the sea on dry ground. And I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they shall go in after them, and I will get glory over Pharaoh and all his hosts, his chariots and his horsemen. And the Egyptian shall know that I am the Lord when I have gotten glory over Pharaoh, his chariots and his horsemen. Then the angel of God who was going before the host of Israel moved and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud moved from before them and stood behind them, coming between the host of Egypt and the host of Israel. And there was the cloud and the darkness, and it lit up the night without one coming near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and made the sea dry land, and the waters were divided. And the people of Israel went into the midst of the sea on dry ground, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went in after them into the midst of the sea, all Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. And in the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and of cloud looked down on the Egyptian forces and threw the Egyptian forces into a panic, clogging their chariot wheels so that they drove heavily. And the Egyptians said, "Let us flee from before Israel, for the Lord fights for them against the Egyptians." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots, and upon their horsemen." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the sea returned to its normal course when the morning appeared. And as the Egyptians fled into it, the Lord threw the Egyptians into the midst of the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the horsemen. Of all the host of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea, not one of them remained. But the people of Israel walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the hand of the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great power that the Lord used against the Egyptians, so that the people feared the Lord, and they believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the people of Israel sang this song to the Lord, saying, "I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation. This is my God, and I will praise him, my Father's God, and I will exalt him." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. O God, you once delivered your people Israel from bondage under Pharaoh and led them by a pillar of cloud and fire through the sea to safety. Grant that we may so follow Christ, that through the waters of baptism we may daily die and rise with him, and walk in safety through the wilderness of this life until we see your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Job confesses the Redeemer from Job chapter 19. "My bones stick to my skin and to my flesh, and I have escaped by the skin of my teeth. Have mercy on me, have mercy on me, O you my friends, for the hand of God has touched me. Why do you, like God, pursue me? Why are you not satisfied with my flesh? Oh, that my words were written! Oh, that they were inscribed in a book! Oh, that with an iron pen and lead they were engraved in the rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, yet in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Almighty God, our great Redeemer, in the sacrifice of your Son, you put to death our wretched flesh, and in his rising restored our life. Grant that we may always cling to Christ by faith in this life, that at the last we may rejoice to stand in our own flesh and see you face to face, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. On this holiest of nights, the whole church of our Lord Jesus Christ recalls his death and burial, rejoicing with great joy in the gospel of his glorious and mighty resurrection from the dead. The Apostle Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. If we have been united with him in his death, we will certainly also be united with him in his resurrection. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be rendered powerless, that we should no longer be slaves to sin. Because anyone who has died has been freed from sin. Now, if we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. In the same way, count yourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. In holy baptism, we are forgiven our sins and granted a new life in Christ our Lord. We solemnly renounce the devil and all his works and all his ways. We confess the gift of faith in God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Lord God, our Heavenly Father, as you offered your Son into the death of the cross and raised him from the dead on the third day, we thank you that in holy baptism you united us to both his death and resurrection. Grant that we may die to sin each and every day and live a new life in Christ unto the everlasting life he has promised us in the life of the world to come. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I ask you anew, do you renounce the devil?
Yes, I renounce.
Do you renounce all his works?
Yes, I renounce.
Do you renounce all his ways? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth? Yes, I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son? Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit? Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Almighty God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given each of you new birth of water and the Spirit, and has forgiven you all your sins, strengthen you with his grace unto life everlasting. Amen. Please stand. Alleluia! Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, you made this most holy night to shine with the glory of the Lord's resurrection. Preserve us in the spirit of adoption which you have given us, that having been made alive in Christ in both body and soul, we may serve you purely. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 20th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Early on that first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter, who was behind him, arrived and went into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been around Jesus' head. The cloth was folded up by itself, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to their homes, but Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. "Woman," he said, "why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet returned to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am returning to my Father and to your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated as we sing our sermon hymn.
Mercy and peace be unto you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Last night, we remembered Jesus' crucifixion. Tonight, we remember our own. Oh, don't worry. There's no cross out back, no nails, no hammer, no crown of thorns or whip. That all belonged to Jesus, not us. That's all Jesus. We remember crucifixion. That's what baptism is. Baptism is not your testimony, your confession of what you do. It is your death. It is your resurrection. That's what God tells us. And Pastor Bender reminded us behind the altar this night. We heard it spoken that in baptism we are joined in Christ in his death and resurrection. We die and rise with him, not symbolically, but really. Should I repeat that? But really. We die and rise with him, not by nailing or bleeding, but by drowning through water and the word. Jesus takes himself through death to life again. The old Adam, the old sinner, is crucified, and the new Adam in us is raised up before God in all of his righteousness and all of his purity forever. You can't do that. You could never do that. You wouldn't do that. But Jesus did. And he gave it to you. Tonight we will remember what had happened to us when we were crucified with Christ, when we were baptized. And maybe some of us might remember that moment. And maybe others, maybe we were too young, too little, too infant to really remember. But whether or not we remember this day is not the point here. We remember the reality, the word and the promise of God applied to us, the gift given to us. And we too were crucified and raised with Christ to new life. It's a promise. It's a gift that we do not remember just this night, but especially this night. But every day we are awakened, we rise, and we remember, I am baptized. Not that I was baptized, not past tense, not history. I am baptized. Present tense. Reality. This is who I am. Because this is who God has made me. The new birth that he has given me. And he has called me his own by his name. And I belong to him. I know we have not always lived that way. And you probably have already known that. We sin. We fall hard. And we fail. And it doesn't take long. But when we do, know that you have a Father who forgives you. A brother who dies for you. And his Spirit who calls you back in repentance and faith to the promises that are sure and certain. Faith that the words and promises are true. That's why we begin each divine service in the same name that we were baptized in. That's why we begin that service. Remember that we are baptized children of God, confessing our sins, and know that our Father welcomes us prodigals back again. I forgive you of all your sins. He says that every week. And we can never hear that enough. But before we get to all that, your crucifixion with Christ, let's review what we heard in the Word tonight. In some of the old and familiar stories, the Old Testament accounts of what God has done for us, His gifts to us. And when you do, think about how these stories teach not about history, but about reality, about today, our baptismal reality. We first heard about creation, how all life came to be by the Word of God. And in baptism, it's the same. New life given through the Word of God in the water. We heard about the flood, how God cleansed the world and saved through water. And in baptism, it is the same, cleansing new life with the Word. We heard Israel passing through the Red Sea and how God swallowed up all the enemies with the same water. And in baptism, we pass through the water and our enemies, sin, death, and the devil are all swallowed up in the same water. We heard from Job the confidence that after his flesh had been destroyed, he will see God with his own eyes, with his own resurrected eyes. And remember, he already said, "I know that my Redeemer lives." In the resurrection of baptism, we have that same confidence. Throughout the Word of God, it tells us of God's joy and salvation, of God's gathering and restoring of His people, which He is doing even now through His Word. And just as we began this service with the service of light, we are motivated to change even some of those old carols that we love to sing. One of them is, "O Holy Night," to the words that match this holiest night that changed everything for us. "Oh, holy night, the fire's brightly burning and waiting for the resurrection of our Lord." Always wanted to sing that carol. But you know, the service back in the 4th century, it started when it was dark. And they had a slew of baptized candidates. And that slew of candidates would last. It was one of the greatest lock-ins of the church in all of history until that morning when Christ arose. So tonight we remember that the death and resurrection of Jesus is the nexus of history. All before leading to it, all after flowing from it, the world will ignore that, point to other things and other events. We know, but we know better. This is the night that changed everything. This is the night that changed us. This is the night of forgiveness. And where there is forgiveness of sin, there is life and salvation. This is the night of life. And finally, the Church of God tonight approaches the source and the summit of all creation and redemption in the sacrament of the altar. Here is fulfilled what was proclaimed. Here the type gives way to the reality, the shadow to the substance, the old to the new, and what was perishing to what remains forever. This is the night when heaven stoops down to earth. This is Christ. All that was stripped away for a time now returns. The hallelujahs, the Gloria Patri, ring out exuberantly. The Holy Communion is the end, but it's also the beginning. It is where we always were going and at the same time where we started. The Easter Vigil, This vigil, this night, dramatically symbolizes and delivers all that we believe, teach, and confess. It is the resurrection, it is the baptism, it is the mystical union, it is life everlasting. Of course, so is every gathering of the faithful around Jesus. So why this service of vigil? It's another opportunity to praise Jesus and be with him. What sets it all apart? Perhaps that symbolic depth of his traditional rubrics, or that lock-in, you might say, on Easter vigil. There is still a lot to see, taste, touch, and smell. I even mentioned that tonight. There's still a lot to see, taste, touch, smell, and hear. It all leads to praise and the glory of God and fills us with wonder. And when there's a chance that we get to bring that wonder, that excitement of the imagination, all from God, especially to our children, then we don't miss the chance. We don't miss the opportunity. We take it up. It is the night of our Lord's resurrection, to be sure. And that night, the night of all nights, it's the night of the Exodus. This is the night when the Lord brought our fathers, children of Israel, out of bondage in Egypt and took them through the Red Sea on dry ground. This is the night when the type gave way to the reality, the old to the new, the perishable to the imperishable, the mortal to the immortality. This is the night when we too are risen from the dead, delivered from the bondage of sin, and restored to life and immortality. Oh, how wonderful. And beyond telling, his mercy really is to redeem a slave. He gave us his Son. He put wickedness to flight and washed away sin and restored the innocent and the fallen and joy to the downcast. So, dear saints, how blessed is the night. How blessed is this night when man is reconciled to God in Jesus Christ. So tomorrow, we certainly remember. We certainly celebrate Jesus' resurrection. Tonight, we remember our own. And don't worry, it is yours too. It's yours too. Your grave will be open and will not be able to hold you when Jesus calls out and says, "Come out," and you will. From death to life, this is the night. And oh yes, I have not forgotten the holy gospel of this night. But there is a huge response to it from you. So are you ready for that response? Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah. Amen.
At this time, our ushers will come forward to gather our offerings.
Thank you.
we stand. We give thee but thine own, whate'er the gift may be. All that we have is thine alone, a trust, O Lord, from thee. Father, use these tithes and offerings for the furtherance of the kingdom of Christ, that many more may be blessed by the events of this holy night, going from death to life. Amen. We pray responsively the litany. O Lord, O Christ, O Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on us. Paschal Lamb, who was offered for us and has taken away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Who was crucified for our transgressions and raised for our justification, have mercy on us. Who destroyed death by dying and by rising to life again brought life and immortality to light, have mercy on us. Whose resurrection was first announced by an angel to the women, have mercy on us. Who appeared to Mary Magdalene and was worshipped by her, have mercy on us. Who revealed yourself to the two disciples on the Emmaus Road and made yourself known to them in the scriptures and in the breaking of the bread, have mercy on us. Who appeared to the disciples, bestowing on them your peace and your spirit, have mercy on us. Who commissioned your church to make disciples of all nations by baptizing and teaching them, have mercy on us. By your glorious resurrection from the dead, good Lord, deliver us. By your victory over sin and death, good Lord, deliver us. By the majesty of your risen body, good Lord, deliver us. We poor sinners implore you to hear us, Lord Jesus, that we may daily day and rise with you in our baptism and walk in the freedom of your forgiveness. Grant us, good Lord, that we may set our minds on things above and not on earthly things, serving others as we have been served by you. Grant us, good Lord, that we may dwell with you forever in the new creation as citizens of the heavenly Jerusalem, together with all the saints. Grant us, good Lord. Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. O Lord, O Christ, O Lord, amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. O God, for our redemption, you gave your only begotten Son into the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection delivered us from the power of the enemy. Grant that all our sin may be drowned through daily repentance, and that day by day we may arise to live before you in righteousness and purity forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord God, Heavenly Father, you gave your only Son to die for our sins and to rise again for our justification. By your Holy Spirit, grant us newness of life, that through the power of Christ's resurrection we may dwell with him forever, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. O God, from whom come all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and also that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may live in peace and quietness, filled with hope for eternity. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have had mercy on those whom you created and sent your only begotten Son into our flesh to bear our sin and be our Savior. With repentant joy, we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and his blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." After the same manner also he took the cup when he had finished supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Now may this, the very body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in that one true Christian faith unto life everlasting. Amen. Please stand as we join together singing the post-communion canticle. Singing the post-communion canticle.
Our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.